On the medical watch now, the CDC says the number of norovirus cases is on the rise across the U.S. There have been at least 91 outbreaks of the stomach bug reported by state health departments during the week of December 5th. There's also a jump in cases of the flu, COVID, and RSV. Dr. Sindhu Aderson is a doctor with Northwestern Medicine, is joining us now live to tell us a little bit more about what to look for and how to react to this news. Hello to you. Thank you for joining us.
Of course. Thank you for having me.
All right. First of all, I want you to give us a little bit of perspective. We hear about an increase in cases. How does this compare to previous years?
Generally, we're seeing a bit of an increase. There is an increase linked to some oysters that has been spread through a certain supplier, which I believe the CDC has addressed. But we are seeing a bit of an increase as, you know, the holidays are here. People are gathering in close quarters. People are traveling. So we are seeing a bit of an increase related to those things.
And you've seen, you know, numbers like this in previous years as well. It may not be related to the same thing, but in terms of the norovirus, you've seen cases before, obviously.
Yeah, generally cases tend to present themselves between November and April. Mm-hmm. Cold season, it's usually cough, cold season, virus season as a whole. People are indoors. And we see the spread just increase in that time period. But this year we're seeing just a slight bit more.
Okay. All right. So let's talk about what folks at home should watch for. What are some of the symptoms that may force them to a hospital or maybe to go and visit their doctor?
Yeah, so big things that we need to look out for are signs of dehydration. Mainly people will present with sudden onset of nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and it's a highly contagious virus. Main things that would require a hospital evaluation is feeling weak, dizzy, peeing less or having very, very dark colored urine, headache, cry. For children, it's like crying without any tears, significant fussiness and sleepiness throughout the day. Oral intake are the signs we want to look for.
Okay, those are good things to watch out for. Thank you. At what point are emergency rooms sort of, you know, because we've got RSV, we've got the flu, we've got COVID, all of these things working sort of together at the same time. Do you feel like emergency rooms at this point are feeling a little overwhelmed? How are they handling all these things together?
Yes, I think at this point in time, we are just focused on just triaging the patients as they come in. If you were to present to the emergency room, we would triage you based on the severity of your symptoms and how you present.
Yeah.
And just get you seen as quickly as possible, just trying to take care of as many people as we can, as safely as we can.
And while I've got you here, of course, we want to prevent the spread. What advice would you give to people?
Main thing we'd encourage folks to do prior to eating or handling any food is to wash their hands with soap and water. Hand sanitizer is not enough, particularly against the norovirus. We just really encourage that soap and water use prior to eating food or handling any food. If you're sick, we'd encourage you to stay home to prevent the spread to others. Mm-hmm. If you have a case of norovirus, you still can be contagious for 48 hours after your symptoms improve. So just be careful related to that.
All right, thank you so much. Good advice. We appreciate your time. Good luck to you and Happy New Year, Dr. Sindhu Aderson.
Aderson, yes, have a
Aderson.
Great day.
Take care. I apologize.
No problem.
Okay. Thank you, good afternoon.
Have a great day, Happy New Year.
Thank you, doctor, all good advice.